We now return to the Senate Foreign Relations Committee and the confirmation hearing of Secretary of State nominee Dr. Condoleezza Rice.
And in the next 4 years, I hope to continue to promote an environment of hope and prosperity alongside the world's global powers. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Well, thank you, Dr. Rice. On behalf of myself and my colleagues, we appreciate your comments. I think it's safe to say that you've got this thing all locked up. So, in the interest of time, maybe you'd like to close with some bullet points.
Freedom, Saddam Hussein, September 11th.
And that'll do it for me. So, unless there's any questions, I think we can...
If I may, Mr. Chairman.
Senator Kerry, you have the floor.
Let me begin by saying that there's no place I'd rather be than right here, back in the Senate. And to think, were it not for that feisty little state of Ohio, I'd be planning my own inauguration tonight. A party that would have included poet laureate Bob Dylan and a performance by the incomparable Savion Glover, bringing in both denoise and defunk.
Do you have a question, Senator?
I do not have a question.
You said you had a question.
Then I do have a question. Dr. Rice, in your opinion, wouldn't that have been a pretty cool party?
Yes, no. No, I don't think so.
Okay, let's just wrap it up. I think we can beat the traffic if there's nothing else.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, if I may. Dr. Rice, I have a few points I'd like to make.
Really? I mean, may I remind you that none of this matters since we're going to confirm this lady anyway? And may I also remind you that I have tickets to the Lion King, Senator Boxer.
Okay, I understand, Senator. Dr. Rice, please, will you take a look at this map? It shows the State Department's list of every country in which Al-Qaeda operated in prior to 9/11. Iraq is simply not there. This is a document where you claimed that Saddam Hussein was planning to launch a nuclear attack in the U.S. in the form of a, quote, your, quote, mushroom cloud. I will be placing this into the record, as well as a number of such statements you've made which have not been consistent with the facts.
Senator, I take offense to your accusation, and I would be very willing to talk to you about this in a more appropriate forum, you know, when there aren't so many senators and TV cameras around. Perhaps sometime after I get the job.
Let me show you something. This is the number zero on a piece of paper, which represents how many weapons of mass destruction have been found in Iraq. Right here is a graph that I made. The yellow bar represents the truth. The blue bar represents what you say. Blue equals lies. As you can see, the blue bar is crazy higher than the yellow.
Once again, Senator, I am going to get confirmed.
Okay, wait. This is a big head caricature of you, and you're lying and playing tennis. This is a plaster of Paris volcano that I made to represent the rising tension in the Middle East.
Now, wait a second. This was supposed to be easy, in and out. She gets the job. We go to the parties.
Cat fight!
The baking soda represents our current situation in Iraq. This vinegar is your lies. When I combine them, look what's happening. A eruption of lies. An eruption of lies from your lie volcano. Dr. Condo lies a lot. You have fooled the people by feeding them a bunch of baloney.
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening. Just trying to make a decision on these business cards. You know, the ones that say Secretary of State?
But that baloney thing really did sum up your argument, I think, Senator Carrot Top.
Bruce Springsteen was going to sing at my inauguration. He had changed the words of glory days to Kerry days. They're finally here, Kerry days.
Senator, do you have a question?
Technically, I do not.
All right, then I move that we postpone these hearings until after the inaugural party. All right, is this gonna happen for the next 4 years?
Yes, I have a lot to say.
Pretty much so. Yes.